Okay, it's just around 6 o'clock. I think we're ready to start here. Welcome to this week's Lowdown on Ridertown here at the Union Station with the Cedar Rapids Rough Riders and 94.1 KRNA. My name is Chad Cooper. I'm here most Wednesdays to host this show. We only have a few weeks left. It's on Wednesdays from 6 to 6:30. A reminder that the podcast of these episodes gets put up on KRNA.com and our YouTube page a couple of days after each broadcast. So usually by the weekend, we have that up there. You can get a link at our website, KRNA.com, or you can visit our Facebook page. It's 94.1 KRNA on Facebook. As we head into the last couple of weeks of this show, a reminder that you could shoot any questions that you have over my way, coop@KRNA.com. Those questions should get through to my inbox. And also, this is a really good opportunity to get to know this team, especially as we head down the stretch here and we head toward the playoffs. Now this week I am joined, as always, by head coach Mark Carlson, but also by players Eric Foley and Zach Court. And as we always do, we'll kind of take a look back here real quick and look at some of the past weekend's action. A split this past weekend, a 3-2 win at Madison and a 4-2 loss up at Dubuque. That puts the Rough Riders at 36-17 with 72 points, and they have officially clinched a playoff berth. And coach, I'll start there with you. Your thoughts on last weekend's action as you guys head down the stretch here?
Well, it was a good game in Madison there and a good battle on Saturday, and looking forward to playing Waterloo on Friday.
And the meaning of, you know, it's obviously a game at a time approach, but the meaning of kind of a clinching a playoff berth for you, I know you had some high expectations for this team coming into the season and set some pretty ambitious goals, but your thoughts on being able to know that you guys are going to have some postseason action coming up?
Well, I think it's great, and I think it's something that our guys should be proud of, and you know, I just have so much respect for this league and the players in it most of all, and all the organizations and fellow coaches and whatnot. And you know, in our league, there's no other league in hockey that exists where fewer teams make the playoffs percentage-wise. We're the only league in hockey where less than half the teams make it. So it's a battle that you start in August, and to get to this point to qualify, no matter where you are, I think is a tremendous honor. And having said all that, you know, we're not satisfied with that. We've got lots of work to do, and we've got to concentrate on the next game here on Friday night.
We have players come on the show, especially ones that have been on here for the first time. I always like to run down their background, their journey in the game, not only of hockey, but also just in life before they got here to Cedar Rapids and with the Rough Riders. And Zach, I'll start on your end, if you could kind of give us a rundown of your time here before getting to Cedar Rapids and some of your background info.
Yeah, I'm from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. It's about a 14-hour drive north from here. So I played in the Midget League there last year. And then I was drafted here in the summer, came up here for both camps, and then, I've been playing here ever since. So,
Eric, your background before coming here to Cedar Rapids?
I'm from Boston, Massachusetts. I played 2 years at Tabor Academy before coming out here, and I got drafted here. It was two years ago, I think, so, and been here ever since.
What's been your biggest adjustment in getting used to this league, the USHL, for you as a player?
I just say the speed of the game. You gotta think a little quicker than you would at the prep level. You know, and there's, you know, a lot of talented players out there. So,
Zach, how about for you for coming to this league? What was the biggest adjustment you had to make as a player?
Yeah, similar to Eric's adjustment there, just the speed and skill of every player. And, you know, back in Manitoba, it was quite a difference of skill between each team. And here, you know, you got to respect the league, and every single player is good, and every player is fast, and every player is skilled. So.
And Eric, you've had some unique experiences in the game, I'd say. You got to play under a former NHL great in a prospects game, and then you've even gotten to play overseas. Can you tell us a bit what those experiences have been like for you as a player, kind of getting some of that kind of unique experience in the game of hockey?
Yeah, it's nice. You know, it's nice to go out and play, you know, against, you know, those players. You know, it's an honor. You know, it's an honor to rep, you know, the red, white, and blue overseas. You know, it's really nice. You know, really just focus on getting 2 points this weekend, so.
Coach, it's coming through. We're getting deep in the season, and it's really coming through. I like that. It's being embedded in the players. Zach, we talked to most players on the show. Usually we're talking about guys that come from maybe another state here to Cedar Rapids to Iowa to play for the Rough Riders, but you've kind of got a unique situation that you came from a completely different country here. What's that transition been like coming here to Cedar Rapids and not only getting used to the game but also getting used to a completely different atmosphere for you?
Yeah, it's a bit different living here. Just especially with a billet family, obviously never been used to something like that. It's a lot warmer here, obviously. I'm from Winnipeg, so it's real cold all the time up there. That's been really nice. And everything's been great here, the whole organization. Like I said, my billet family. It's been great. It's been a bit of an adjustment, but I think I've done pretty well for it.
And coming from Canada, obviously we know the rich tradition in hockey up there and the rich history. Is that kind of what got you into the game, or what kind of got you interested first thing into a game of hockey?
Yeah, no, for sure. Everything in Canada is, you know, hockey related. I mean, you turn on the TV, it's hockey, and it's a bit different down here. I mean, it's harder to find games on TV and stuff like that, but definitely just the culture of hockey in Canada got me into the game, and my dad played pro hockey, so he kind of helped with that a little bit, and then when I was 4 years old, I started playing in my backyard. So.
And Eric, similar history or similar tradition out on the East Coast, but what got you into the game firsthand?
My dad, you know, he had a lot of influence in me, you know, stepping on the ice, and he'd bring me out there when I was little, and I just fell in love with the game when I was little, and liked playing, and got in a couple house leagues, and just took off from there.
And Coach, I'll touch on you as we come down the stretch here of the season. I wondered if you could kind of take us inside of practice and give people that listen in here and that are out in the audience an idea of what a typical practice session is like for you as a coach and for these players day in and day out.
Well, it kind of depends on the time of year. Beginning of the year, practices are a little bit longer. Monday through Thursday might be an hour and a half, sometimes 2 hours. And at this time of year now, I think Monday we were around maybe 75, 80 minutes, and yesterday we were somewhere around 50, 55, I think. And today we were at, 48 minutes or something like that, so it was a little bit, quite a bit shorter, and try to pare it down as the week goes.
And guys, as players, this is a developmental league, a developmental franchise. When you came to this organization, what was kind of your biggest goal as far as portions or elements of your game that you really look to improve on, or something that you kind of pinpointed? Eric, I'll start with you.
Coming to this league, you know, you always want to develop, and I kind of wanted to, just kind of sharpen up my game all around. it really helps you playing against, all these talented players, because, it kind of becomes second nature to you at one point. So, glad I made the step.
Zach, how about you as far as improvements or things that you kind of had goals in mind when you got here with the Rough Riders?
Yeah, well, it's my first year of junior hockey, so last year being in midget, it's, a lot less physical, smaller players, younger guys. So I think coming down here, I've gotten to play against a lot bigger, older, mature players, which has helped a lot. And then the speed here is, a lot faster pace than it is back home. It's a different game. So I think coming down here, it's been a big improvement for me. It's just getting used to the speed of the game and the skill. So
I'll take a moment here before we get back to questions really quickly, just remind people that we're in the March Madness time of year, and that's a season ticket promotion for the Rough Riders. Covered this a few weeks ago, I think, too, but tickets for next season, 2015-2016, are on sale now. Some added benefits to that, including early bird pricing, free autograph poster, and free scarf for new season ticket holders. You can learn more on that and get your tickets right now at RiderTownUSA.com, or you can get more information at the Riders Facebook page. And Coach, I'll get back with you about upcoming here next week. We have a Wednesday game coming up next Wednesday. Don't notice a whole lot of those onto the schedule. For the most part, there's a lot of weekend games. I wonder, how do Wednesday games work into the schedule, and is that more of a matter of convenience and just maybe out of necessity, or how have those kind of worked in for your team, but also just for the league as far as fitting in midweek games?
Do we have a game that exists past this Friday?
Well, no, you don't. You don't. But I'm not asking about the opponent. I'm asking about the schedule. I try to sneak it in any way I can get them in. I like to disguise my questions now.
No, that's a good question, Coop. Good question. No, the Wednesday games are the Wednesdays are good. I think the guys really like them. I like them, especially the second half. You know, we've got a lot of practices in already, so it's nice to play. We have those. We kind of call it more of a pro schedule. You know, a couple of days of practice and a game, and then you know, be a real light. You know, 25, 30 minutes on that Thursday, and then two games on the weekend. So I think it's a real good thing, and I think it's a great thing in the community too. Something you know, to do on a weeknight here at this time of year, and so we'll be excited for that one.
And I'll ask you guys as players too about not only Wednesday night games, but also just that schedule. The fact that it's a little more like a pro schedule, something you would see in the NHL. The fact that you're playing games on a pretty regular basis in front of some pretty big crowds. Zach, what's that been like for you to kind of get adjusted to that and that type of schedule?
Yeah, no, it's a different schedule. Obviously, the regular schedule, just playing on weekends, a lot different than what I'm usually used to back home. I mean, every second or third night I had a game. So, I mean, back to the Wednesday thing, it's nice having that kind of a pro schedule, like Coach said. But yeah, no, the atmosphere at the games too is just incredible with all the fans and stuff. I've never gotten to play in front of anything like that, and it's been really great with all the support.
Eric, what's that been like for you, that type of schedule?
Yeah, you know, I like the schedule a lot because it's, you know, you're really you know, you're out there playing games, and you know, it's nice to kind of, you know, get that little pro experience in there with, you know, the light practices and all that, and the atmosphere at the games is great. You know, it gets you jacked up to play, and you know, I love it.
Let's touch on college commitments real quick. I know with both of you guys, you both have college commitments. One guy headed back out east, and another one kind of staying around this region, so to speak. Eric, I'll start with you. You're headed back out east. You committed to Providence, correct?
Yep.
And what kind of went into that decision with you? Why'd you kind of settle on Providence and feel like that was a good fit for you as a player?
You know, yeah, I like how it's close to my home. You know, just right there, and my, you know, my parents can go see me play, you know, all the time, and I just like the operation that Nate Lehman's running down there. He's a really good coach, and he's got good assistant coaches too. So I mean, you know, I really like the campus and everything too. So.
And Zach, you headed over to Nebraska Omaha, correct? What kind of went into that decision for you to kind of you know, pick that as your college destination?
Yeah, no, I went down there for my visit at the beginning of the year, and I just liked everything they had to offer. Great facilities there. They got a brand new rink coming next year, I think, and then great coaching staff there, and a lot of experience with Coach Dean Blaze there. So that was a big part of my decision there. And I mean, it's decently close. I mean, it's 9-hour drive, I think, directly south of Winnipeg. So it's one of the closer colleges to my house. So yeah, I'm really excited about that.
And looking at, you know, outside of the game, you guys are kind of obviously have lives outside of hockey, and many times school, work, any of those things go into it. Zach, I wonder if you could kind of give us an idea of what you do outside of the game of hockey and some of your commitments outside of the Rough Riders.
Yeah, no, I graduated from Linmar High School about 2 weeks ago. I just had a lot of credits from my old school, so I was able to graduate early, which was nice. So, I mean, now I'm starting to come to the rink early in the morning, kind of work on little individual skills, stuff that, you know, you don't get to work on as much in practice, stick handling, shooting, and stuff like that. But I mean, outside of hockey, I'm pretty dedicated to Netflix. I watch a ton of that.
That seems to be a constant theme on this Rough Riders team.
Yeah, I watch a ton of Netflix and play a lot of Call of Duty, so that's about it.
Eric, how about you outside of hockey?
You know, yeah, outside of hockey, I'm a big Kevin Hart fan. Love to watch Kevin Hart. I'm a big Call of Duty guy too, so I mean, get a nuke or two on the weekends or something, or so.
Are you guys into the, I've heard there's kind of a ping pong rivalry or somewhat along that lines. You guys in on that rivalry too?
Yeah, I mean, there's a little monkey that we get passed around the room, and I've had that in my stall for quite some time now. So I beat Dylan McLaughlin. He's probably the next best player on the team, so.
Eric, how about you as far as ping pong is concerned?
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to toot my own horn, but I'd probably say I'm probably the best on the team.
I've heard that from at least three different guys, so I think we're gonna have something happen here.
But yeah, you know, we have fun with it. You know, we go in there and play a couple games of ping pong. Hacky sack's a big thing now, and you know, it's, you know, we have fun in the locker room. You know, keep it light.
Coach, have you thrown your hat into the ping pong rivalry ring?
I have not. These guys are they're way better than me at ping pong, so I stay out of that.
Guys, as far as you're looking at the NHL, do you guys have a favorite NHL player or a team or somebody you kind of try to emulate your game off of? I try to ask when we have players on, kind of if they pattern their game off of somebody or somebody they look up to. And Eric, I'll start with you.
Growing up, I was a big Boston Bruins fan, and I love how Patrice Bergeron plays, and former Bruin too, Nathan Horton. I love how he played too, so I kind of try to model what I do off them and their work ethic and stuff like that. So,
Zach, how about you?
I'd say kind of a Zach Parise. I like to, he's got a really good work ethic, all around player, solid defensively, and still able to play really solid offensively and make plays in the offensive zone. But I'm a big Winnipeg Jets fan, so guys like Andrew Ladd and newcomers and Matt Stafford or Drew Stafford, sorry. So it's been really good.
And Coach, we talk a lot about the community influence that this team has. I know there was a recent article in the Gazette detailing the meaning of the recent ALS night that you guys did with the Rough Riders, and how important are those community events for you and those charitable events? I know the Rough Riders have a lot of theme nights, and most of them are kind of fun themed and oriented around kind of fun activities, but also some serious things and things that really do help the community and have a little farther reach.
Well, I think it's real important. It's a big part of our organization, right from ownership, right on down. And we think it's real important too for the players' development to get out and be involved in the community and get out and and speak a little bit at times and be involved with the people and help the people that aren't as fortunate as us and at times help raise some money for good causes. So I think it's all part of being an organization and being part of a community.
For you guys as players, Zach, I'll start on your end. Has there been an event or something you've been involved in that you've really kind of thought was really fun or something you really enjoyed doing here around the community?
I think the ALS night and the cancer care night back a while ago, I think in October, was both pretty good nights to raise awareness for causes like that. And then in the mornings lately, I've been going out and helping with some little kids clinics on the ice with our assistant coach Doug Leverton. So it's just been really nice to help out a little bit with the community.
Eric, how about you as far as community events and kind of getting out and getting involved?
Yeah, I did Meals on Wheels once, and that was pretty cool. Go and deliver some meals to people that maybe can't maybe afford them or stuff. So I mean, it was really nice to do that. And going to the games. I mean, the ALS game and the cancer game are really really fun games to play in. It really gives you it gives you a reason to go out there and leave it all on the ice. So.
And, Zach, we started off this show tonight by kind of talking about postseason action, the fact that you guys have clinched a playoff berth. What's that like for you to know that you're going to have some postseason action and being able to kind of get that experience under your wing, too?
Yeah, it's really nice. I know the boys are pretty excited, but I think we're more excited, and we're real prepared for this game against Waterloo on Friday. So.
And, Eric, I'll come at the question from a different angle, see if we get a different answer. Last season, you kind of joined this team during the postseason action, kind of got thrown into the fire, so to speak. What was that like for you to join this team, not only making the transition, but also coming in at a pretty heated time, playoff action?
Yeah, it was nice, come in and get that experience. Those were my first couple games in the league, so it was nice to come in and see what the league's all about and see, what the playoffs are all about. But, really just looking forward to getting 2 points this Friday against Waterloo.
You guys have months and months of action under your belts at this point. What's it like at this point in the season? Is it kind of a grind, or does the adrenaline start to pick up for you guys a little bit when you start to get close to the playoffs and down the stretch here? And, Eric, I'll start with you.
Coming down the stretch, you kind of get fired up because the playoffs, right around the corner, and you got other stuff like the Anderson Cup and stuff. You want to, make a run for that, but... it kind of gives you a little juice out there, to play. So,
Zach, how about you? A little motivation as you come down the stretcher?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a little bit of extra motivation for, a couple of cups, like Foley said, and the Anderson Cup, especially a long playoff run. But it is also a grind. Just like Coach said, we're kind of watching practice, and we're all prepared for it. So.
Now, the Rough Riders have a lot of theme nights. We kind of talked about that, and they also have a lot of fun theme nights. I wondered, with you guys as players, if you could pick what kind of theme night, what one night would you guys have the Rough Riders put on, if you could pick any type of theme to base a game around? Zach, I'll start on your end.
Oh, that's a tough one. Come back to me. I'm going to have to think about this.
Eric, are you ready?
Yeah, it was a tough one, but I mean, I was a big fan of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles when I was younger, and then I liked how we had that one a couple months ago, so I'd say Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Night was pretty good.
Zach, are you ready yet? Do you have something in mind?
Yeah, I think Navy SEAL Night would be pretty cool. I'm a big fan of the Navy SEALs and American Sniper, Lone Survivor, so I think that'd be pretty cool.
There you go, some ideas, just dropping some hints in the hat, so to speak. Right. Coach, is there something that, Rough Riders haven't done in your 15-plus years with the organization that you really like to see based around a theme night?
I don't know if we've done a 70s night or not. I think a 70s night would be cool. Get some 70s unis going and some 70s music. I think people will be into it.
For sure. So we've got a few ideas heading into next season for the Rough Riders. This show has more than one purpose, just to let you guys know. Tell us a bit about you guys' host families as players. When you make the transition here to Cedar Rapids, you have to not only get used to a new city, new organization, but also a family that you live with. And Eric, I'll start with you a little bit about your host family and what that experience has been like.
Yeah, I mean, my host family is great. I live with Janelle Banowitz and Doug Banowitz over there, and they have a little kid, Nick Banowitz, and a big kid, Brian Banowitz. So, I really like they're real great people. It was really nice to me. Always getting putting food on my plate. Janelle's a great cook, so.
So you guys kind of have a sibling rivalry there too. I know you mentioned that the other kids are in the family.
I guess so. I mean, I live with Andrew Goss and Cal Burke, and we're always playing pool and stuff, and kind of get a little competitive in those things, but it's great. It's a great time.
Zach, how about you as far as the host family and getting used to that transition?
Yeah, it's been a bit different, but I've really enjoyed it. I live with the Harm family up in Marion. They got two billet sisters, Kaylin and Kylie. One's a freshman in high school, and the other one is a freshman at Kirkwood. So it's been really good. They're great family, great to me. Like Foley said, food on my plate, and they've just been really good to me, so I've enjoyed it.
I know a few of the guys that we've had on have spoken specifically about favorite dishes that they've liked as far as what their host families prepare. Anything that you really look forward to, Zach, on supper time?
I think there's quite a bit, but she makes really good, they're called score bars. So, a little dessert after dinner. It's pretty good. Probably won't help me out in Berkey's, but I really enjoy it.
Eric, how about you?
I have to go with chicken Alfredo. She makes a great chicken Alfredo, so.
You guys talked a little bit about, what you're doing in high school outside of the game of hockey. I know, Zach, you just said you recently graduated. What has it been like kind of around the high school environment, that atmosphere? Obviously, you're kind of in a different sports realm than the other guys that are going to high school. They might play basketball or football in front of a couple hundred people maybe at most, but you're playing in front of some pretty substantial crowds at night, and you're playing to get to a pretty high level. What's that been like around high school for you and kind of making that transition?
Yeah, no, it's a bit different at my high school. A lot of the kids weren't really sure anything about hockey. They're more into basketball and baseball and football, obviously. So it was a bit different explaining to them, what the Rough Riders were and what junior hockey is all about, and how it's the first step before NCAA. So it's been a bit different, but I've met a couple kids in my school when I was going there, and great guys. And they seem to enjoy hockey too, so they came out to a couple games. So
Eric, what's that support been like for you, or what's that kind of transition or being in high school with the other students been like?
Yeah, it's good. a lot of them probably don't know I play hockey because I don't really talk a lot in school, but it's good, because it's kind of difficult to explain the USHL to them if they don't really get hockey and they don't really know what it's all about, junior hockey, how it's kind of like a feeder for the NCAA. So it's good though, because you get to talk to them and you get to tell them about your experience out here and stuff.
And have the students that you've gone to school with, have they been out to some games? Have they been out to some Rough Riders games?
Yeah, I had a couple of my buddies come actually from Boston a couple weeks ago, and it was nice to have them there. So.
And Coach, we talk about players going through the system and eventually going on to college, and then many of them have goals to go on and play professional hockey. What's it like for you as a coach? Obviously, you're running a developmental program. You like to see the kids that are playing under you go on and succeed. But what's it like to see those players go? Is it kind of bittersweet for you as a coach?
Well, when they leave at the end of the year.
It is tough.
And sometimes I explain this to them, but I haven't yet this year. But, you get used to coming to the rink from mid-August until hopefully the middle of May. And then all of a sudden, one day, like, no one's here. You're still having 23-plus guys here, and then all of a sudden, they're not here anymore. So it's, when you love it the way I do, it's not easy there at the end of the year.
As you guys as players, what's the biggest thing you've been able to take away from Coach, but also as just from this organization as far as kind of helping your game out? Zach, I'll start on your end.
Just everything about the organization and all the coaching staff, just really, respectful and everything. I mean, from taking your hat off of the dinner table to, every little thing. So it's been really good, from the front office to the coaching staff to our trainer. So, I mean, there's so many things you can take out of it. I probably can't even choose just one.
Eric, how about you? Some takeaways that you've had under Coach Carlson and under this organization?
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of great people in the organization. You got Doug Lieberton out there, Shane Connolly, a lot of great people, Jay Bird down in the front office. So, there's a lot of great people, there's a lot of class in the organization, and there's just a lot of stuff you could take out of it.
And people can obviously tell from tonight, too, and from the guys that have been on the show, there's a real family atmosphere, pretty tight-knit group of guys on this team, right, for both you guys?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we're all pretty close, yeah.
And, Coach, we have a few more questions here before we wrap up tonight, but we'll look at the game right ahead here coming up with Waterloo. I wonder, in your mind, how important has it been to kind of have those close in-state rivals like that? I mean, it's not too far to travel, but also it kind of seems like that breeds some excitement around all the cities that are involved, whether it's Waterloo or Dubuque or even heading out west a little bit. You guys seem to have some pretty good excitement around the game of hockey with some of those close rivals.
Yeah, I think it's great, for sure, for all three cities. When you're talking about the ones that are right here, I think it's great for everybody. And so those are good. I think it's been great for Eastern Iowa, for sure. And, but I always say, I think any game in our league is a great one. They're all entertaining. They're all exciting. And so I think any night we're playing at the Stable, it's an exciting hockey game.
And we'll wrap up tonight, as we always do, kind of asking you guys your final thoughts as we head into this weekend. Zach, I'll start on your end.
Yeah, no, I think we've had a really good week of practice here, so getting prepared for Waterloo, which is, our main focus right now, and then Dubuque on Saturday. So I think it's, had a good week, and we're prepared and focused, and get another good day of practice in tomorrow with some video, and we'll see how it goes.
And then, Eric, two games coming up this weekend. Your thoughts as you head into this week's action?
Yeah, I'd say, we had a really good week of practice, and I think the boys are fired up to go out there and get 4 points. So,
Coach, we'll give you the final word as you head into this weekend, two games of action here with Waterloo and Dubuque.
Well, my favorite part of the show tonight was that we made the announcement that we have a Jay Bird in the front office.
Yeah, I like the nicknames. Everybody gets a nickname. So
everyone knows we have that now.
Yeah, for sure.
So that's a good thing. And it's been good to have the 3 days so far of practice. We got tomorrow, and guys have been working, and we've been just trying to get better every day like we have all year. So I think we've improved here this week, and be a real battle on Friday. So it's going to be a hard-fought game for sure.
Well, thanks again, guys, for making the time and coming out here for the lowdown on Ridertown. I appreciate making the time tonight for us.
Yeah, thanks,
Coop.
A reminder that the upcoming games for the Riders this Friday, March 27th, versus Waterloo, it's Kung Fu Fight Night. We're talking about theme nights with the Riders, complete with a Kung Fu demonstration during intermission. That sounds like a lot of fun. And then Saturday, March 28th, they're going to be up at Dubuque. There's only three home games left this regular season. Friday, the one we mentioned, and next Wednesday, and then Saturday, April 11th. Because of that game next Wednesday, we won't have the show here next Wednesday, so it'll be the following Wednesday, April 8th, and we only have a few more shows left this season. Thank you, as always, for coming out, and we'll see you Wednesday, April 8th, for another show of the Lowdown on Ridertown. Thanks.